Hello everyone, this is Manjunath Naik. Welcome back students. In this session, we are going to learn the sorting elements of an array. Arranging elements in a specified order, either in ascending order or in descending order, is called sorting. If arrays are having numerical values, then the values are sorted on the basis of their values. If characters or string type, then the values are sorted according to the ASCII value. Well, there are many types of sorting techniques. In this session, we will be learning on bubble sort, which is most frequently asked sorting techniques. You will understand why we are using bubble sort and the practical applications of it. And without wasting time, dear students, let's get started. So, given an array of items, the bubble sort will sort them in increasing order. The items could be integers, strings. For example, we will just use a sample short list of integers. We have 6 items in our unsorted list of integers. We are going to number them from 0 to 5. Now, the way the bubble sort works is repeatedly compares adjacent items in the list. And then, if the item on the left is larger, it swaps to the right. So, the larger item tend to bubble to the right. So, this will show you the comparison of one iteration. It's going to compare adjacent items. So, in our first comparison, in this bubble sort is going to compare 5 to 8. If 5 is greater than 8, then we will swap the first two items. 5 is not greater than 8, so no swap occurs. The next comparison compares 8 to 1. If 8 is greater than 1, then we will swap which it is. So, we are going to swap these two items. Move 8 to the right and 1 to the left. And then we will go to our next comparison. Compare 8 to 6 is 8 greater than 6. If yes, then swap it. So we will swap these two items. Next comparison compares 8 to 9. 8 is not greater than 9, so there is no swap. And next comparison 9 to 2. 9 is greater than 2, so we will swap these two items. So, after one iteration, this is what our list looks like. Now, if you compare to the original list, you can see that the larger item works to the right and the smaller item works to the left. But after one iteration, 2 is still here and 1 is still here. One thing is for sure is that the largest item does not work its way all the way to the right. It bubbles all the way to the right, the largest item in the unsorted part of the list, which is 9 here. So let's look at the next iteration. So we will have 9 highlighted in gold because it's already been sorted. We are only going to look at items 0 through 4 for the second iteration, which is unsorted. So, is 5 greater than 1? If yes, swap. 5 is greater than 1, so it is swap. Is 5 greater than 6? No, it's not. Is 6 greater than 8? Is 8 greater than 2? Yes. If it is so, swap those two items that completes our second iteration of the bubble sort. We can see that the rightmost items are completely sorted. The rest of the list is partially sorted. The one has worked its all the way into the leftmost position. But some of the other items are not going to correct orders. So after two iterations, we have two items on the rightmost end of the list that are completely sorted. The third iteration is compared 1 to 5. Is 1 greater than 5? No. Is 5 greater than 6? No. Is 6 greater than 2? It is. So, we will swap them. That completes our third iteration. So, note that we stop the iteration when we reach the item that we know are already sorted. So now, we are half done. We have completed three iterations and we can see that the three rightmost items are completely sorted. And the three leftmost items comprises the unsorted part of the list. Next iteration will compare 1 to 5. 1 is not greater than 5. We will compare 5 to 2. 5 is greater than 2. So, we are going to swap these two items that completes the fourth iteration. And the 5 is now considered sorted. So, our last iteration, although we can see the list is completely sorted. Now, the algorithm does not know that. So, it's going to do one more iteration to compare the two unsorted items. It considers unsorted 1 and 2 and then it realizes, wow, 1 is not greater than 2. So there is no need to do any swapping and finally we are done. So the sort is finished, that is our sorted list. So to code up the bubble sort in Java, we will use I for an outer loop variable and J for an inner loop variable. And I have after two iteration, this is what the data set looks like. Just to demonstrate how far we want J to go, we really only want J to go 0 through 2. And we will compare items J to J plus 1. Dear students, finally we are in the ending stage of this program. So let us start coding. In the beginning, we shall have public method that returns an integer array. And you can see our written down here is the same list that we have accepted. So variable we are going to do use I for outer loop and J for inner loop and a temporary variable to do the swaps. Our outer loop is going to run from 0 to the length of the list minus 1 and the inner loop is going to run from 0 to the length of the list minus I minus the number of items that are already sorted, which is the number of iterations we have already completed. And then for inside the inner loop, where each time we are going to do one comparison. We are going to compare an item to the item on its immediate right. If the item on the left is greater than the item on the right, then we swap the two items. Dear students, in the next session, we will be learning on conditional statements in Java.